Good afternoon. Our first main in this competition we have done is to be the first in the group, but we respect this competition and we respect Qarabag, and tomorrow our objective also is to win, and we are going to give players chances tomorrow for take responsibility, take rhythm, take confidence, and also because we are going to play a lot of matches in the next 10 days. We're going to play 4 matches, and very important, every match very important. But is in Europa League our first objective we did, and we are going to use tomorrow some different players, with also players coming from under 23 teams, and also, for example, tomorrow in our planning is to start with us playing Laurent Koscielny.
Oh. Unai, you mentioned Laurent Koscielny. How is he at the moment, and how ready will he be to start in the league game against Southampton at the weekend, and how do you manage that availability problem you've got at centre-back at the moment?
Yes, we have some players with injuries, and above all the centre-back, and also with these injuries is Mavropanos and Rob Holding, and with the not possibility to play for yellow card. And we are going to decide after tomorrow match, because it's the first match with us. Laurent Koscielny is going to play, and we are going to look also if he can play 90 minutes, he can play less minutes in this game. And we can use another player in this position, like sometimes he's playing Nacho Monreal, also with us, and in his career he played in this position Listeiner, and we are going to decide, but the first is think in the match tomorrow, also because we need to receive information how he can feel tomorrow, Laura.
You've got Mesut Ozil back after a back injury, but one of the theories doing the rounds at the moment is that he has maybe picked that up by playing too many computer games. I just wondered, is there any truth to that? Do you think that's true?
Se dice que la lesión de Mesut de la espalda se le debe a jugar demasiado videojuegos. Es algo que es verdad. ¿Qué piensas de esa teoría?
I don't know. Tomorrow is in the group, in the 18 players in this the first for this match in the squad, and we are going to decide if he will play tomorrow at the beginning or during the match in 90 minutes.
Raheem Sterling's treatment has made widespread headlines this week. What do you tell your players about how they cope with facing abuse from the stands?
Tras pues la noticia de Raheem Sterling, que ha sido una de las noticias más llamantes de la semana, ¿qué dices
¿Cuál?
A tus jugadores? Raheem Sterling, lo de
sí.
¿Qué dices a tus jugadores sobre cómo deberían comportarse cuando reciben esos insultos?
It's not acceptable, but I think it's very a small contest or one small moment. I think the people is conscient the respect to every people, and I think it's one contest in one moment, but is not acceptable this commitment.
And a lot has been said and written recently about players, Arsenal players' lifestyles. I was just wondering if you've had a chance to speak to them about how they lead their lifestyles after what was written last week?
Has hablado mucho sobre el estilo de vida de algunos jugadores del Arsenal. No sé si has tenido la oportunidad para hablar con los jugadores sobre las noticias de la semana pasada.
The club said to you, this discussion is inside between us. But for me, the most important is not to lose the focus. Our focus, and our focus is first is last matches against Huddersfield, and now is the matches tomorrow and Sunday. And I trust in my player. I trust this behavior is good behavior. And the most important is every day how I can. And I am seeing every player training with us and with a big behavior, with a big commitment, and with the focus for us and for our work.